I warmly welcome all the ladies and gentlemen present over here. So you are listening to Omkar Dalvi and I am currently pursuing BTech in Lovely Professional University. So I am here to put down some shine on the topic active participation of youth to eradicate corruption. So to eradicate corruption, we require individuals who are incorruptible and undoubtable. So what produces such individuals is spirituality. So there is a saying that violence begins in the mind itself. This is also true that corruption also begins in the mind itself. So if we alter our thinking, we would have safely said that we would have eradicated corruption by at least 50%. What changes the heart and the mind for better is the spirituality. When an airplane takes off, it reaches to some higher altitude where it is capable of flying to reach its destination without any hurdles. Similarly, a spiritual seeker is able to fly at some higher altitude where he is free of negative influences, negative thoughts, negative thinkings, and negative aspects. So there are two aspects of the spirituality. One is theory and another one is practice. Basically, spirituality is a non-materialistic approach to life's issues as opposed to other approach that is based on materialistic interest. One who is spiritually giving more importance to non-material values, and it is his only non-materialistic approach that can eradicate corruption, since the root cause of the corruption is materialistic approach. Applied spirituality enables one to infuse daily life with spiritual values, and those who do are so able to distance themselves from all these bad practices, bad dirty practices. One aspect of the applied spirituality is duty consciousness, which is it induces a right conscious person can only see what is his own interest, while the duty conscious person looks to well-being of the others. How to inculcate this spirituality among people? Basically, it is a part of education, both formal and informal. Education means mind training, with special emphasis on inculcating high values. To spread spiritual values in the society, we need value-based education, especially during schooling. So what is preparatory prayer for life? If we want to build a spiritual society, we must adopt a value-based education. So there is a saying that a wise man is one who knows the relative value of the things. The wise person is the one, moreover, who has predictable character. All these qualities stem from spiritual training, makes him strong from spiritual training. It is the responsibility of reformers, therefore, to train people to become duty conscious, or for the duty conscious person can never involve himself in the negative activities such as corruption. So if a society is to be free of corruption, it has to be made or evolved for at least evolving individuals who have fairly strong sense of what is right and what is wrong. This is the only solution to the problem of corruption. This is the right beginning, and the only right beginning can make it possible to reach the desired goal. Hope the country is free of corruption soon. Thank you.